We worship you. We worship you. We worship you, oh Lord. We worship you. We worship you. We worship you, oh Lord. We worship you. We worship you. We worship you, oh Lord. We worship you. We worship you. We worship you, oh Lord. We worship you. We worship you. We worship you, oh Lord. We worship you. We worship you. We worship you, oh Lord. We worship you. We worship you. We worship you, oh Lord. We worship you. We worship you. We worship you, oh Lord. We worship you. We worship you. We worship you, oh Lord.
Welcome, everybody. We're going to begin in prayer here, and I'm going to let you know, I'm going to tell you why. And those who are late, we'll try and get them in with us. And we pray that they're not late to heaven, because they are going to miss out. So let me encourage you, first of all, try and be on time to the house of the Lord. You guys are here, so I don't know how they're going to hear this, except you encourage them and remind them about it. So, what is going on? What time is it? Well, let me tell you. Some amazing things are going on right now in the Congo. Right now, as I am speaking to you, Pastor Mark is getting ready. He's having to speak in front of these chiefs and kings. I actually have kings still there in these that kind of govern these areas. So, this is a very important time in this region of the Congo, and we believe with all our hearts it's strategic. So in another minute here, we're going to begin to lift up our voice in prayer. Those of you who know how to pray in the Spirit, those of you who know how to pray the effectual, fervent prayer, we're going to begin to lift up two things primarily. One, we're going to cry out to God for an outpouring of the Holy Spirit through Pastor Mark, because we want to see these kingdoms ruled by these kings unlocked. And the way these regions work, to my understanding, is if you can get the kings, if you can get these leaders to experience God and the presence and His awesomeness and just be overwhelmed and touched by the Spirit of the Lord, you've got then an open door to the nation. So that's what we're going to begin to pray for. The other thing, the other prayer here too, is that we're going to believe that the Spirit of the Lord breaks through upon them like the bursting of a dam, to where the water courses of heaven that have been held back, that whatever would stand in the way to stop, to hinder, to push back, be broken, so that just these waves, this river of the Spirit comes in and brings life to the land and region. So I'll remind you of anybody else that walked in. It's four nights. It starts tonight. It's nighttime in the region of Africa, the Congo. And so right now it's about to happen. So right now we're just going to begin to pray. Father, we thank you. We thank you that by your Spirit you speak through Pastor Mark. Lord, that you open up the doors that no man can shut. Lord, that you open the way. Lord, that you touch the heart of these kings. That you touch the heart of these chiefs. That they be changed. That they be changed. That they have a real encounter of Jesus Christ. in Jesus Christ, in the kingdom of God, in the name of Jesus, that there be a bursting, that every dam, everything that would try and hinder and block the flow of the Spirit, that it be blown up, annihilated, so the water courses of heaven can rush in, oh Lord. Oh Lord, we cry out for this. Lord, break forth upon them like the bursting of a dam, the rushing rivers of heaven in the name of Jesus. Lord, I think of these 4 nights that there'll be radical signs and wonders right now, Lord, that your glory just penetrates every heart. Your glory penetrates your life, your spirit, your miracles, your signs, and your wonders in the name of Jesus. Just begin to keep praying with me. Let's let the roar of heaven, the sound of the Spirit be heard in us. Lord, that the hearts of these chiefs and leaders and kings even be turned. Lord, that they have encounter with you just as Paul did, where he just falls flat. He encounters the true and living God. Did they encounter you, this people group? This people group that's been held in bondage by witchcraft and all sorts of sorcery and plague of the demonic, that have been held in oppression, locked in a prison of deception. It's broken in Jesus' name. Thank you, Lord. You give us the keys through these leaders. You give us this keys, the strategy of heaven. Keep going with me, saints. We're starting with this for a reason, because this is the first day of the week, and we're taking the first time that we appear here to intercede for these 4 nights that are going on in the Congo, that are key meetings with chiefs and kings in the regions. So we're just going to continue to pray. Who knows how long? Oh, thank you, Father, that it is your will that all men come to you, to know you, to be saved, to be rescued from every ploy of the demonic, every deception of hell. And I thank you, Lord, for the outpouring of your Spirit. Oh, we cry out to you, Lord, for the outpouring of your Spirit through Pastor Mark tonight. There will be undeniable miracles. Undeniable miracles, undeniable signs and wonders, those that turn the hearts of men to you, for they are unmatchable, undeniable, undeniable. Healings, healings, multiple healings, lives completely changed around and baptized in your fire, baptized in the Holy Ghost and fire. They receive Jesus as their Lord and Savior, and you come rushing in and fill them with the Spirit in Jesus' name. Lord, that there be no hindrance, and every hindrance be moved out of the way. Every hindrance removed in Jesus' name. Every hindrance removed in the name of Jesus. Every hindrance removed. Obra mandero kunjala la basobra bajebro babajesho. Obra basiabre bebre basobra babra basabra. Obra dade shulo lo basa. Obra ba. In the name of Jesus, Satan, we break every claim that you have over the Congo region, over every life of these chiefs, over every life of every king. Oh, Jesus, we thank you that you have all power and authority in heaven and earth, and that every chain and bondage is broken in the name of Jesus, in the name and by the blood of Jesus. Congo, yield up to the kingdom of God in the name of Jesus. Congo, Congo, let there rise such an army of God from Congo in the name of Jesus. Urubadnia dola badialalo.
Lord, that these kings and chiefs not even be able to move, but they're just stuck, so captivated by your glory, so overwhelmed by you, so overwhelmed by the things of heaven. Oh, begin to intercede with me. Continue. Pastor Mark said he believes this is so important. He said it was almost even more important than a national crusade. It was that important. So that's what's going on. For those of you who are coming in late, bless your heart. Four nights, which starts right now as we're speaking. Pastor Mark is speaking to king, to chiefs and kings that hold the door to regions of the Congo that have been held prisoners from the gospel of Jesus Christ. Places that if you and I went, we wouldn't even know. How does this still exist on the face of the earth? How do places like this still function? It'd be like stepping back in time. Something that would be so foreign to us in this world. We look around in cities and all these technologies and whatnot. We go there, they have nothing. They have nothing. So let us, as the abiding place, those who know how to prayer, be in prayer and intercession, begin to proclaim by the Spirit of the Lord, His will, that every bondage be broken, that there be no hindrance. In Jesus' name, in the name of Jesus, that the Spirit of the Lord break through upon them like the bursting of a dam. Everything that would hinder and have stopped the river courses of heaven, annihilated and blown up, so that the river, the rushing river of heaven, rushes through in Jesus' name. Rushes through in Jesus' name. Lord, the mighty signs and wonders. Lord, we cry out for the outpouring of your Spirit tonight as Pastor Mark delivers your word. Make it sharper than everything he's ever experienced. So sharp that it cuts through everything into the souls of these chiefs and kings that hold the key to these nations, to these regions. In Jesus' name, oh, the Congo. Lord, you said for us to ask for the heathen for our inheritance, the uttermost parts of the earth for our possession. And right now we're focused on the Congo. Give us the Congo, Lord. Give us these chiefs. Give us these kings. That everything come in alignment with what you purpose. That they be allies to everything in the kingdom. That they might be so overwhelmed by the revelation of the kingdom. That they open the door wide. Oh, that you fill their hearts so full. That they fall down. That they fall flat on their plate, on their face. And say, surely God is here. Surely the living God. Surely the one my soul needs is here. I have found Jesus. I have found the one that my soul sought after. I have found the one. In the name of Jesus. Lord, once again, this petition goes out that the Spirit of the Lord break through them. Oh, break upon them like the bursting of a dam. The bursting of a dam. That which is hindered, where the gates have been shut, where the city has been fortified against, the walls sink down in the earth and are overrun by the power and forces of heaven. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Oh, We bind every spirit of witchcraft that has had power and authority over that region. Powerless. In the name of Jesus. No hindrance. In Jesus' name. No hindrance. In Jesus' name. That you melt the hearts, Lord. That you melt the hearts. The hardest hearts of stone melt like wax. Melt like wax at your word. Oh, at the fire of your word. At the hammer of your word that busts the rocks. In Jesus' name.
Father, we cry out to you for this nation. We cry out to you for these leaders. We cry out to you for the kings and the chiefs to have great breakthrough, God. Father, we counter with you, Lord Jesus, that everything in the life comes into alignment, oh God. Oh, church, intercede. This is not the time to think about you. Oh, church, intercede. Intercede for this nation. This is the time to intercede for this nation of the Congo and what's going on in Zambia. This is strategic. Do not miss this opportunity to be a part of what God is doing. In Jesus' name, waken church and intercede. Intercede. Cry out to God. Cry out for souls. Cry out for souls. Cry out for souls in Jesus' name.
Souls. Many souls. In the name of Jesus, we cry out for the souls of the Congo. You beautiful people of Congo. You beautiful people. In the name of Jesus. Your region is held in captivity no longer. The days of your captivity are over. The time of liberty is at hand. The time of freedom. Oh, thank you, Lord, for your minister. Thank you for Pastor Mark over these next 4 days. Right now, being the first fruits, being the first time gathered together with these key leaders and chiefs and kings of the Congo region. In the name of Jesus, no weapon formed against shall prosper. There'll be such extraordinary miracles and signs and wonders. There'll be such undeniably so that every heart is melted, that every heart is broken, that they begin to sob. Oh, that these strong men begin to weep and sob like babies at the presence of the Lord, that they become overwhelmed. In Jesus' name, I take captive everything of stubbornness. I take captive everything of the will of man that would try to prevent the will of God. In Jesus' name, thank you, Lord, that there will be the outpouring of the Spirit that will be like the bursting of a dam. 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 In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name, that the mighty rushing rivers of the Spirit come forth and heal the land. Be healed, Congo. Be healed, Congo. Be set free, Congo region. Be set free, Congo region. Be set free, Congo region. Thank you for the mighty flow of heaven through Pastor Mark right now. Oh, such an intensity. Such an intensity of the anointing, of the glory, of the power of heaven. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Lord, we thank you for strength right now. Thank you for strengthening him right now. Strengthening his body. Strengthening his inner man. That your word have free course, O Lord.
Let your word have free course, O Lord. Lord, we cry out of contempt for the Congo. We know your ears are open unto the righteous. So we lift up our voice, knowing that many souls weigh in the balance. Many souls weigh in the balance. And who will intercede on their behalf if we do not? So we will. In the name of Jesus, we command every life of every chief, of every king, of every leader to be so broken, so soft, so humbled before God that nothing would stop the miracles, that nothing would stop the signs and the wonders, that nothing would stop the flow of the Spirit. We thank you, Lord, that this is part of an eternal strategy to reach the region of Africa, to reach these people, these bush people, these people that I've never seen, but I've only heard exist because of your servant, Phil Smethurst, and the Overland Mission teams, who are willing to go where nobody else can go, to go find people to reach. And we thank you, Lord, that this is the pinnacle. This is the point of the arrow. This is the sharp part of the sword right here. The tip that would stab to bring and put to death everything of the enemy and every claim of the enemy over the region of the Congo. In Jesus' name, that these leaders give up. These leaders surrender over to the kingdom of heaven. In the name of Jesus, that there come such a mighty outpouring of the Spirit of God in Congo. That there come such a mighty outpouring of the Spirit in the Congo. Oh, that every leader be brought low, humbled, and just so overwhelmed by the glory of God. So overwhelmed by the indescribable love that melts the most calloused heart. Oh, for your servant, Lord, strengthen the hands of your servant, Pastor Mark. Strengthen his hands. Strengthen his body for the work. Strengthen him. Lord, we cry out for strength, and we participate in strengthening by interceding that everything of hell, that the intercessions of hell be stopped by the intercessions of the saints. Oh, the intercessions of hell are real. That's why we need the intercessions of the saints. The intercessions of the saints. The fervent, effectual prayer of the righteous avails much. Lord, you made us righteous. And so we cry out again. Give us a Congo. Give us these leaders, these chiefs. Lord, that no man be able to stop and stand, and nothing of darkness be able to hinder. In Jesus' name. Lord, we thank you for such a mighty outpouring of the Spirit. In the name of Jesus. In the name and by the blood of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Lord, that there comes such a bursting. That there comes such a bursting. Such a breaking forth. Break forth, O Lord. Break forth, O Lord. Break forth, O Lord. Mighty rivers of heaven. Mighty rushing rivers of heaven. Mighty rushing rivers of heaven. Break upon them. Like the bursting of a dam. Like the bursting of a dam. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, every captive, every one of these chiefs and leaders that have been held captive in bondage and the deceit of the enemy and the deception of witchcraft, broken in Jesus' name.
Broken in Jesus' name.
that no weapon formed against would prosper. That you mold them over with your glory, Lord. Even any army that would try to resist, that you mold them over with your glory. Mold them over with your glory, just as you did in Old Testament times where you went before the praises and the prayers of your people and annihilated kingdoms. So supernaturally, by your miraculous power, we thank you that you do this, Lord, and even greater works than these. For we are on this side of your covenant. We have been made partakers in Christ. New creations for the new covenant. Heirs and joint heirs, so we can speak out. Speak out the prayer and intercession of heaven to stop every intercession of hell. In the name of Jesus. In the name and by the blood of Jesus. Every captive set free. Every captive of the Congo set free. We thank you, Lord, that there's going to be such a movement. Such a mighty movement. A revival in the Congo. Oh, that no one thought was possible. That no one thought was possible with these regions of people held in such bondage. Those that people would go in and be bewildered by the power that they're able to wield through the demonic. But all of that turned around so that the power of heaven and the glory of heaven, like that dam that bursts forth, rushes in, and the water of the word, the water of heaven knocks everything over. That it knocks everything over, moves out of everything out of the way. That the old things become drowned. And that the water sinks in of the word to the ground to bring forth much fruit. To bring forth much harvest. To bring forth much harvest in the Congo region. Saints, just keep going with me a little longer. For those of you who came in and don't know what's going on. First, try to get here on time. We don't want you to be late for heaven or else you're gonna miss it, I'm afraid. But we are interceding right now as of when the meeting began. Pastor Mark was standing in front of chiefs and leaders of the Congo region. And it was communicated by Pastor Mark that is such a strategic thing of heaven that he said it was a greater than any national crusade that could be going on right now, because these leaders hold the keys of these regions. They function in a very old system where the kings, they say what's going to come into their country. They rule. And again, there's a lot of ground we've already covered. But we are interceding two things. If you know nothing else how to pray, we want you to pray that, cry out to God that there'll be an outpouring of the Holy Spirit through Pastor Mark as he preaches. That there'll be an outpouring of the Holy Spirit through Pastor Mark as he ministers. That every prison be unlocked, and these chiefs, every prison unlocked, and these kings, so that they might be turned to be priests and kings of the living God. Oh, those of you who know how to pray, let's keep going on a little longer here. Again, this is serious business. Oh, you'll get to look back and have it be accounted to righteousness. Because you took the time to pray and intercede and drive back every force of hell, every intercession of hell, in the name of Jesus. Lord, we cry out again and again for this Congo region, this region that has been held in darkness, this region that's been held in the captivity and slavery of sin and the demonic. Every chain broken. Every chain broken. Every chain broken. Every hindrance removed. 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 That the word of the Lord would have free course. That the word of the Lord would have free course. That the word of the Lord would have free course. Of the mighty signs and wonders begin to happen. Even now, even as the word's going forth, men begin to break, men begin to sob, men begin to weep like little babies. Strong men, that when the Spirit of the Lord manifests, they fall to their face, weeping and crying because of the reality of God and His love. Oh, Your love, O Lord! Your love, O Lord! Invade every region, invade every part of this Congo region now, to the deepest places of the hearts of these kings, those that have become calloused and as stones, their heart has become a stone in the name of Jesus by a miracle. It's turned to soft flesh, the softest tissue possible, that they melt out of the presence. Oh, for the very hills melt like wax before the presence of the Lord. Lord, Your presence. Lord, Your glory. Lord, Your presence. Lord, Your glory in the Congo. Lord, Your presence. Lord, Your glory. Oh, I'm Pastor Mark as he's speaking right now. Your word. Such a strength today. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Every captive set free. Every captive set free. Every bondage broken. Every bondage broken. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Such miracles. Oh, even this first night, right now. Such extraordinary, supernatural, undeniable miracles. Such supernatural, undeniable miracles. Oh, Father, we thank You for it. We thank You for it, Jesus. We thank You for this work by Your blood that is possible. And Holy Spirit, that You're there moving and brooding among and upon the people now. Oh, such signs. Oh, such wonders. That tonight, even as we pray today, right now, this time, which is night there, that the dam breaks. That the dam breaks. That the dam busts. That the dam busts. In Jesus' name. In the name of Jesus. That the rushing rivers of heaven come forth. Come forth. Rush. Rush. Rivers of God. Rush. 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 Rush mighty rivers of God upon the Congo. Upon the Congo. Lobujala Lobaya. Let the intercessions of heaven, let the intercessions of heaven flow. Oh, Your mighty signs, Your mighty wonders, Your mighty miracles, oh God. Undeniable, unstoppable power and presence. Oh, for we've tasted and seen, Lord, what that presence does to us. It causes us to melt. It causes us to break. It causes us to weep. It causes us to laugh. And we pray for this region of Congo, that there be such a moving of the Spirit even now. Such a moving of the Spirit now. Such a moving of the Spirit now. The people around are just bewildered. They're caught off guard, saying, what's going on? What's happening? I've never felt this way before. I feel free. I feel free. As the word of the Lord goes forth through Pastor Mark, they say, I feel free. I feel free. That the miracles take place. Miraculous healing. Tumors dissolving off of people. Every kind of extraordinary miracle possible. Where limbs grow out. Where eyes that aren't even formed appear. Oh, Father, it is the time. It is the time. Lord of the harvest. Your laborers are there. Though they be but few, they're there. For such. Pour forth such supernatural signs and wonders. Such supernatural signs and wonders. That the dam breaks. That every hindrance is broken. That every opposition of hell flees and dissolves. Yolo jolo bajala baye yolo baka. Yolo bashaya yo balay. Oh, those of you who know how to pray. Those of you who know how to let the deep Holy Ghost intercession by the Spirit. Let's begin to pray. Let's begin to pray. And of course, as the Spirit gives utterance, you can pray with the understanding as well. Yolo bashaya baklo yolo bako. Yolo bashini namando. Yolo bashaya. Yova bashaya. Yova kaya. Yolo bashaya. Your force of hell. Be driven back in the name of Jesus. Come go. The Lord has need of you. Come go. Your eyes be open to see. Come go. Your ears be open to hear the gospel. Your hearts receive in the name of Jesus. That every leader comes to the revelation of the sovereignty of the Almighty, of the Sovereign Lord, and sees himself as weak as a little mouse, even weaker. As a worm that would be crushed upon the master's bidding. Oh, Congo, yield up! Congo, yield up! Yulabashe! Ulabatai! Lokasheo! Yulabashe de Bakai! Yulababai of Maya! Ulabujai of Kuka! Yudukashikaya, Yotakala Luba, Uvishervaka, Udivu Piaja, Ubiyatuya, Yopiyasha, Yopika. Thank you, Lord, you teach the saints their hands to war and their fingers to fight. So that at the right moments, we're not having to be caught up, but we're already caught up in heaven to go forth and conquer. To see the captive set free. Jalala Bafate. Ubidala Vashaya. Ulava Vietu Dubai. Yulava Kole Vavia. Yulava Shavia. Yulavia Vyaya. Yulavia. You sorcerers, you witch doctors. I command your power to be shut. Your mouth to be shut. Your eyes to be blinded. And more importantly, your life to be given over. Where you say, surely I have seen strange things. For I have seen the power. The supernatural power of God. that goes beyond anything I've seen through my sorceries, through I've seen through my witchcraft. In the name of Jesus, once again, we bind every spirit of witchcraft. We bind every hindrance they'll try to stop out and lay claim. For it has to the region for a long time. But Satan, we drive you out. And we drive out your power in the name and by the blood of Jesus Christ. In the name and by the blood of the Lamb slain from the foundation, slain to set at liberty the captives, men that through disobedience became captive and subject, slaves of sin, slave to the whims of the demonic and Satan. And we say once again, O Lord, let your spirit break through upon them like the bursting of a dam. Like the bursting of a dam, so the mighty rushing rivers flow forth, mighty rivers. Lord, we cry out for the mighty outpouring of the Holy Spirit through Pastor Mark. Tonight, this first night, that there'll be such extraordinary miracles. The faith is stirred, and many come to see the marvelous things the Lord has done. Lord, on these next 4 days, that you completely rearrange structures, the structures of regions, the way the authorities have worked, because the gospel goes forth. And as precious seed is sown, that there be quick supernatural fruit for a great and mighty harvest, for a great and mighty army of people raised up in the Congo region. A mighty army that can spread forth through that region, through those unreached people groups, and take many, lead many out of their captivity into the freedom and liberty of Christ, into life eternal. We thank you for it, Father. We thank you for it, Lord. We thank you, Sovereign Lord, that you alone are able to do this. You alone are able. You who hold the world and all therein. You who brought forth the mountains and the sea and set boundaries. You who carved every region. You who know the region of Congo better than any expert, for you have created it. We thank you that even now is the time, the supernatural time, that what was a wall even as a dam that would hold back and prevent the gospel from being effectual in the Congo, that it burst and break at the word of the Lord. Even as the word is going forth right now by Pastor Mark. Even as the word goes forth. The fire of your word. The fire of your word. With the fire of your spirit. Lord, we will be those who know how to turn the battle to the gate, for we know the battle is not ours, but is the Lord God of armies. The Lord God of hosts. And we command by the Spirit that you have given us. We command with the voice of the Spirit and say, Congo, go free. Congo. Go free, you chiefs and kings. Go free. Congo, you chiefs and kings. Go free. The days of your captivity are over. Your divine appointment with heaven is here. Your divine appointment is here. We cry for the souls. The souls of the people, the souls of the region, the souls for the kingdom, in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. Hearts and lives turned around, hearts and lives turned right side up, hearts and minds rearranged. By the miracle of salvation. Thank you for the miracle of salvation upon this whole region of Congo. And we thank you for the miracle of salvation in every chief, in every king, in every leader that is gathered there. Every leader, the salvation, the miracle of salvation, and the baptism of the Holy Spirit and fire. I hear the cry of heaven. I hear the cry of the Spirit.
It's mine, says the Lord. Yes. It's mine. Claim it in Jesus' name. It's mine. I've called it mine. I've called it done. Everything comes into a line in Jesus' name. Break through. Break free. Break free in Jesus' name. Washanta, every power is broken. Every power is broken. Every stronghold is broken. I claim it as mine. I claim the souls as mine in Jesus' name. Usha Congo, you are mine in Jesus' name. Every king and every chief, their spirit comes into the alignment of the kingdom of heaven. Usha Mbaya City, Ashandana City. I claim the encounter of Jesus Christ on every soul, every person who would hear. I claim the life of Jesus Christ. Yeah. I claim the souls of the Congo. I claim the souls of the Congo in Jesus' name. Yes, oh, Father, we come before before you and we petition you, God. Oh, we stand in the gap, oh God, and we claim it as ours, oh God. Oh, we cry out to you, oh God.
In your mercy, show forth your glory, Lord. In your mercy, show forth your glory now. In your mercy, show forth your glory. In your mercy, show forth your glory now. In the name of Jesus. As the word is going forth. As the word is going forth now. In the name of Jesus. Supernatural signs and wonders. Supernatural, undeniable miracles. In the name of Jesus. In the name and by the blood. Oh, we thank you for it, Lord.
We thank you, Jesus.
We thank you for the power and authority you've given us. That as we proclaim your will, you bring about the impossible. For you are the God who makes all things possible. And there is nothing too hard for you. There is nothing too hard for you, Lord. And there is nothing that can stop your plan and your purposes in the Congo. The Congo, Lord.
The Congo, Lord.
Give us the Congo, Lord. Give us the Congo, Lord. Give us the Congo.
The Congo.
Every soul in the Congo. Every life. Not one. Left out, not a one. Left unreached. There is no limits to your supernatural power, God. There is no limit. We thank you for such that outpouring. Even as that dam is just blown up. That your glory covers that region.
Yes, oh God, your glory.
And everyone in that region has a supernatural encounter with the one true God. That they all come to know the man, Christ Jesus. God who took on the robes of flesh. To bear the most brutal punishment, to be mocked by man, smitten, reviled, as a lamb to the slaughter. Yet he opened up not his mouth, so that he might reach them, so that he might turn and be the offering, the seed that went down to the ground to bring forth much fruit. And we command much fruit now in Jesus' name in the Congo. We command much fruit. We command a harvest, a complete harvest, a complete harvest. That all the harvest be gathered. That all the harvest be gathered, for the harvest is ripe. Lord, the harvest is ripe in Congo. We thank you for strengthening Pastor Mark now in his spirit,
in his body, and that the word go forth with free course, that their outpouring of the Holy Spirit be manifested greater than anything seen in Nepal, greater than anything seen in Papua New Guinea, greater than anything we've seen. We thank you for it, Father. Just begin to lift up your voice with a shout. Hallelujah! 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 I see some of you don't opening up your mouth. What's up? What's up? Lift up your voice. Let's go. Hallelujah. Lord, we bring this offering of praise. Lord, we bring this offering of praise. We bring this offering of praise. Hallelujah. Oh, we thank you for your word. Oh, we thank you for your word. Oh, we thank you. Oh, we thank you. Oh, we thank you. Oh, we thank you. Hallelujah. 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 Oh, the Congo. Oh, the Congo. I see the Congo. I see the Congo coming. I see the Congo running. I see the Congo coming. I see the Congo running. Running to Jesus. Running to Jesus. Congo, come running. Come running into the arms of a loving Savior. Into the arms. Congo, come running.
The Congo, come running.
The
Congo comes running. The Congo comes running.
Congo, come running. Congo, come running. Oh, come running. Come running, Congo. Come running to Jesus. Come running. Thank you, Lord, that your word causes us to leap over every wall and run through every troop. That you make us wise by the wisdom of your word. Woo! Woo! Hallelujah! Let the saints be glad. Oh, for he that is mighty has done mighty things for us. Oh, he that is mighty has done mighty things for us. He that is mighty has done mighty things for us. I tell you, church, he's got more for us than a hand clap. Although the hand clap is good. And he says, clap your hands. He does say that. But he's got more for us than a frozen statue. He's got the life. He's got the life of Jesus. Oh, which glory that fills my soul. Glory fills my soul. Your glory fills me. Your glory fills me now. Your glory. Your nominajado. Invading Congo now. Invading Congo now. Oh, Holy Spirit invasion. Holy Spirit invasion. In the name of Jesus. Oh, we love you, Holy Spirit. Oh, we love you, Holy Spirit. We love your church. Holy Spirit, forgive us where we thought your church was a building where we just met, came in, sat down, listened to some words. God, maybe a positive message. Maybe we had one that was, we thought, condemning. But really, it was the way we were supposed to turn. Oh! We thank you for your word. Lord, we will not limit you. We're going to be a church so baptized. Baptized in the Spirit. Baptized in Jesus Christ. Baptized and flowing in heaven. That every member has something to bring. Yes. That people walk in here and they're blown away and encounter heaven. Welcome everyone this morning. I feel now like we could keep praying the rest of the day. And so I feel at liberty now to maybe begin to make a little bit of a change. I wait for that to happen. I wait to feel a change. Because I'm not in charge, and neither is anyone else. Amen. Who stands in this place. But we give ourselves completely to the Holy Ghost.
Yes, amen.
And the Lord knows we already scared off some visitors. But we pray that even things that just look crazy, me up here screaming, there's a beauty in it for people that want truth. You know, people that really want truth, they're going to see something in it. Because yes, there's been crazy charismatic stuff that's gone on, and all I can do is apologize to some people about it. But there is the truth and the true church that in a moment of a drop of a second, if the Lord tells us to do anything, we'll do it. Anything. Doesn't matter. Doesn't matter. Doesn't matter. And I'm so thankful for the people that are gathered here with that. You know, I hear different people, Tim Hall was saying, you know, I come to the abiding place, it's like the seals. And that's awesome that, you know, we have that reputation. But really, we're just going after what the Lord has instructed the church. And it's a sad thing that that has not been a reality, that it's been almost held in bondage by men, where we have our 20-minute sermon, lay me down to sleep prayer. And God forbid, and I almost hate to say it, but a communion that's just... it breaks my heart. For the body and the blood that he gave, so sacred. And yes, he said, as often as you do it in remembrance of me. But I've seen so much in the church. Who will live out their life as if they've never gone to church, even though they take what represents the body and they dip it in the cup and they eat it. Oh, not realizing what it must have took for the Father to offer his Son. Oh, how beautiful may it become fresh revelation this morning that he's called us to communion every day. And how much more so the first day of the week, Sunday, when we gather ourselves. That we present ourselves. It's almost before like a communion table. It's an altar. That said, your body was broken for me. So break every part of my will. So I not be self-willed, but God-willed. And your blood was shed at Calvary's tree to be the life source that I could live. Amazing God. Oh, the Lord is so good. I'll tell you what. He'll touch the deepest parts of you. I don't care how much of a strong man you think you are. When you really break, when you really break under the Master's hand, under his love, you'll weep. You'll sob like a baby. And I pray that every heart, that there be nothing of stubbornness, nothing of callousness, but such a sensitivity. For we remember, there's a lot more than us. You may have had a flat tire on your way here. The dog, your dog might have bit you, or, you know, anything. But you know that when you come in the house of God, you recognize, you don't really know what's going to happen. You never know when you'll be called upon by heaven to begin to intercede for a nation, for a region. And I'm so blessed by everyone that's gathered here together. Don't get me wrong. But I'm telling you, I've just moved. This is all given over to the Lord. Every time I stand up here, I don't care how long you've been doing this. I don't care what your resume is. It's nothing. As Paul said, it's like dung. It's that worthless. But it's by the Spirit. And I'm so thankful, guys, for you that are willing to come. But let me encourage you. Because when I just feel things to exhort you, I'll absolutely tell you, you know, Just remember to keep God first. Remember to be on time for the meeting. Remember, I started off saying, you know, you don't want to be late for heaven. I'm afraid you'll miss it. I'm just telling you, these are my words. These are my words. Just a vessel the Lord fills. And I praise God for this house full of vessels of honor fit for the Master's use, that He can fill and let His water courses come through to reach the world around us. Oh, hallelujah! And I just want to encourage you. Let's lay hold of God. We don't know what we're supposed to be doing. Let Him show us how we're supposed to move. How we can manifest that love the Lord with all your heart. Oh, with all your might and strength. We love You so much, Lord. Lord of heaven, God of all creation, hallelujah. I'm just going to briefly begin to minister to you guys. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Oh, the Lord is so good. Ha. The Lord is just so good. Ha, ha, ha. Remember not to fix your eyes on the earthly, but only see heaven. Where we are seated together with Christ. Seated in heavenly places. So I'm going to really briefly talk about our confession here. And I pray, and maybe those watching on the web, that our confession be one of faith, hope, love, life, truth. One that is just, pure, lovely, of good report, joyful. Oh, that it has peace, long-suffering, gentleness, goodness, meekness, temperance. Oh, and righteousness and good works. One that you can acknowledge and confess with certainty. This. I am right in the middle of the will and plan. I'm right in the middle of the working hand of God. No matter what circumstances I see that I might think are coming out against me, that I know that I am right in the middle of the will and plan, right in the middle of the working hand of God. So let me remind you of those things. I'm just going to say it one more time, because I believe it's so important for us to remember that. That when we have our lives completely surrendered over to Him, where we have said, Your will, Your way. And we are those who are content with food and raiment. And we're not distracted and led about, as I believe as 1 Timothy 6 talks about, that there were some who went after the pursuit of riches. And it then talks about they were pierced through with many sorrows. That's not us. But we're those who are right in the middle of the will and plan, right in the middle of the working hand of God. Hallelujah. So let's begin with Ephesians 1, please. And while you're turning there, I'm going to remind you of some of the confessions that are highlighted here before we read it. That your confession be, I have grace and peace from the Father, verse 1. That I am blessed in Christ with all spiritual blessings in heaven. And key emphasis there, in Christ and in heaven. Ha! That it doesn't matter what situation I find myself in. I could be homeless and there might not be any room in an inn. Oh, but in Christ I have all spiritual blessings in heaven. And I'm living for the eternal heavenly purposes. Because that's where I'm blessed to spend eternity. Woo! And such a blessing that I'm going to see you guys in eternity. This people of the abiding place. That abide in His grace. Abiding, abiding, abiding. Hallelujah. Well, for your sakes, I'm going to keep going on here. We're going to be covering quite a bit of ground here. But what I'm getting at here, and I'll say it a few times, is the confession. What is our confession? What are we called to confess? And what would be, in examining ourselves, be confessing that would be stopping the blessing? We are accepted in the Beloved, verse 6, to the glorious praise of His grace that endowed us with the grace in the Beloved. And there's not any greater grace than that. Ha ha! Ha! Great grace. That we are redeemed. That your confession be, I'm redeemed, I'm forgiven. And whom? Because I possess redemption through His, Jesus' blood. From the release of trespasses. That's verse 7. I've obtained an inheritance, verse 11. I'm going to go ahead and I'm sealed with the Holy Spirit of promise. That's another confession, verse 13. So let me, now that I've highlighted two of them and seated with you with that, about your confession, let's read it. And I'm going to be reading from really the apostle of the abiding place here, Pastor Mark Spitsbergen's translation. I can personally attest to the validity of it. Anyone doubtful can download the PDF. It's a substantial length of pages that shows different footnotes of why he's translated things in their most literal Greek translation. And it's beautiful because, you can open up right here, the King James Version. And you read it, and it's the Word of God. And you read it over here, and it's just a little bit more parsed for us today to really know maybe some adages or words in the English language back then that maybe meant something that they don't quite mean today. So here we go. You can follow with me if you just have the King James Version, or if you have handy the Pastor Mark's translation. Verse 1, here we go. Paul, an apostle of Jesus Christ, by the will of God, to the holy ones, which are at Ephesus. There we go, the first one, holy one. Let that be your confession, I'm a holy one. And to the faithful in Christ Jesus. May that be another confession, I'm a faithful one in Christ Jesus. I'm a faithful servant of the Lord Jesus. Oh, and we're going to get to that keeping power of God in a minute, I think. But that your confession be, I'm a faithful one in Christ Jesus. And it's part of what you see through your daily life that something would try to pull you over to being an unfaithful. Something would try to lure you away into some kind of lust or something of this world, of pride of life, cares of the deceitfulness of riches. You remember, I'm faithful in Christ Jesus. I'm in my place in Christ. Verse 2, grace and peace to you from God and Father. My confession that I have grace and peace in every dimension of my life. And anything that would witness that that's not true, I say, no, that's not true. I have grace and peace from my God, from my Father. And you begin to declare by the word of God the way things are supposed to be. The confession that you create the world around you. And praise God, it's as I see it right now, you know, we're given a place where we can create the world around us basically individually, right? Our family. Where we can love our wives as we're supposed to. Through our confession, we can edify our children, our friends, right? Our confession could be good things, because if it's not, you know, and your confession is something else, that's where, other than the word of God, that's where, you know, some havoc, hurt, disappointment, things happen that create a world, that your little world, that can become chaos. But praise God, as I'm exhorting you this morning, and I believe unto edification, to remind you of the confession of the word, and remind you the confession of the promises that he's given for us in this life. For our lives are hid in Christ. We're hid in him. And this is such, doesn't even hold true, but it'll resonate with some of the youth in here, that God's got your back. And it's even more than that. He's got you. He's your defense. He's your suzerain. He's your shield. He's the guy that steps in, you know, you don't mess with my kid, you know. And it's just so beautiful, the love that he created. And I'll keep going here because I'll just get captivated and continue speaking by the Spirit things that will help you, but I'm going to try and focus. But there's so much here in this epistle that Paul wrote to the Ephesians. Verse 3, blessed is the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who has blessed us in Christ with all spiritual blessings in heaven. And again, we talked about that in one of the bullet points. All spiritual blessings. Our confession being, I'm blessed with all spiritual blessings in heaven. Verse 4, just as he has chosen in him before the foundation of the world, that we should be holy and without blemish before him in love. He predestined us to sonship. A confession, I'm a son unto himself by Jesus Christ, according to the good pleasure of his will. Verse 6, to the glorious praise of his grace that endowed us with grace in the beloved, and whom we possess redemption through his blood and release from trespasses according to the riches of his grace. Again, the confession, I possess redemption. I've been released from trespasses. Verse 8, which abounds to us in all wisdom and insight. He made known unto us the mystery of his will, according to his good pleasure, which he has set forth in him, overseeing the fullness of times to bring together all things in Christ, both which are in heaven, which are in earth, in him, and whom also we have obtained an inheritance, having been appointed to the plan of him who works all things after the counsel of his own will. The confession that I have an inheritance in Christ. Verse 12, that we should be to the praise of his glory. My confession is, I'm to the praise of your glory, Father. I'm to the praise of your glory. And there's nothing so beautiful and glorious as the Almighty's glory, the Father. Ha! Who first had confidence in Christ, in whom you also, when you heard the word of truth, the gospel of your salvation, in whom you also believing, were sealed with the Holy Spirit of promise. The confession, I'm sealed with the Holy Spirit of promise. Which is the first installment of our inheritance as a ransom payment for the purchased possession under the praise of his glory. Therefore, I also heard, after I heard of your faith in the Lord Jesus and love unto the holy ones, cease not to give thanks for you, making petition for you in my prayers, that the God of our Lord Jesus Christ. The Father of glory may give unto you the spirit of wisdom and revelation, the knowledge of him, that the eyes of your understanding being enlightened to know the confidence of his calling and what is the riches of the glory of his inheritance in the holy ones, and what is the exceeding greatness of his power to us who believe, according to the working power of his mighty strength, which worked in Christ when he raised him from the dead and set him at his own right hand in the heavens, far above all principality and authority and power and dominion and every name that is named, not only in this world but in the one to come, and has placed all things under his feet and appointed him the head over all the church, who is his body, the fullness of him that fills all in all. I'm not going to go into it, even though I'd like to. Ephesians chapter 2, but I'm going to remind you one of the gems of confession there, and it's, I'm his workmanship created in Christ Jesus unto good works. That's Ephesians 2:10. Hallelujah. Now I'm going to give you guys a couple rapid-fire scriptures here, reminding you of your confession. Galatians 2:20. I am crucified with Christ, nevertheless I live, yet not I, but Christ lives in me, and the life which I now live in the faith, in the flesh, I live by the faith of the Son of God, who loved me and gave himself for me. My confession is that I live in and by the faith of the Son of God, Christ Jesus. 2 Corinthians 5:21, for he hath made him to be sin for us who knew no sin, that we might be made the righteousness of God in him. That confession of righteousness, the confession of I'm the righteousness of God in Christ Jesus, and I'm not going to let such riches, such pearls of great price, such treasure be robbed from me, because I am and will choose by my conduct and actions to choose righteousness, to hunger and thirst after righteousness, for my confession is, I am the righteousness of God in Christ Jesus. Real quickly, let's turn to Philippians 4:8. This verse reminds us the things we are supposed to be thinking of, and also that they'll be our confession. For out of the abundance of the heart, the mouth speaks, as Luke 6:45 tells us. And we want our heart to be so full of heaven that there's no room for anything of the earth, anything of evil or leaven, but of only heaven. So 4 verse 8, here it is. Finally, brethren, whatsoever things are true, again, our confession of truth. Whatsoever things are honest, our confession, our speech, the things we're talking about, honest. Honest. I mean, really honest. It's truth. It's not something we think we heard or we think we know or something we created in our mind, scenario, or something that we heard from someone else who knows where it came from. Many times straight from the pit, unfortunately. But dwelling in the honest, the asking, is my conversation and my confession truly honest? Lord, let our conversation and meditations be the true, the honest, the just, the pure, the lovely, the good report, the virtue, the praise. Oh, these things, Lord. Whatsoever things are true, whatsoever things are honest, whatsoever things are just, whatsoever things are pure, whatsoever things are lovely, whatsoever things are of good report, if there be any virtue, if there be any praise, think on these things. Another confession, acknowledge every good thing which is in you in Christ Jesus. Philemon 1:6. That I am complete in Christ Jesus. The Lord, you're perfect in everything that concerns me. Oh, Jesus, you're so good. Another rapid fire of commands that you guys know, but just to remind you. Romans 12, verse 9. Let love be without dissimulation. Abhor that which is evil. Cleave to what is good. Be kindly affectionate one to another with brotherly love. And honor preferring one another. Not slothful in business. Fervent in spirit. Serving the Lord. Rejoicing in hope. Your confession being one of rejoicing and joy in hope. And our true hope. Our true confidence of glory in Christ. Continuing on, patient in tribulation. Continuing instant in prayer, distributing to the necessity of the saints, given to hospitality. Verse 14, bless them that persecute you, bless and curse not. Rejoice with them that do rejoice and weep with them that weep. Be of the same mind one toward another. Mind not high things, but condescend to men of low estate. Be not wise in your own conceits. Recompense to no man evil for evil. Provide things honest in the sight of all men. If it be possible, as much as you can, live peaceably with all men. Dearly beloved, avenge not yourself, but rather give place under wrath, for it is written, vengeance is mine, I will repay, says the Lord. Therefore, if thine enemy hunger, feed him. If he thirsts, give him the drink, for in doing so you shall heap coals of fire on his head. Be not overcome with evil, but overcome evil with good. Again, that confession of us being ambassadors that show forth his love. No matter what people would do to us, that we could show and shine with the light of Christ and our confession. And by our confession, our action being in line with those things that we are confessing that we're are meditating, thinking on the Philippians 4:8 group that produces then the action. Another confession, Romans 1:17, for the gospel reveals the righteousness of God that comes by faith from start to finish, just as written, the righteous will live by faith. And in the King James it says, the just shall live by faith. My confession is I'm righteous. I'm just, and I live by faith. And to underscore, again, the importance of our confession and the things we're speaking out that would either edify those around us or God forbid, tear them down. The power to create, to bring inspiration. How beautiful a thing it is that we can give hope. No, even as you are able to, you know, just as a kind of carnal example, say a kid doesn't think he can do something. And you step in there and you show him, no, you can do this. You can do this. Let me show you how. And how you bring hope to even a little kid. How you completely make them light up and what was impossible to them before they're able to walk in. The same we can create and edify and exhort those around us in love and show them, no, you got this wrong. Let me show you this. But his words, by these peaceable fruits of righteousness, by this love, we're able to show and help people and bring hope where there wasn't hope and show them the way that was made where there was no way. Ha! So that they too and us could truly be found under praise, honor, and glory in Christ, filled with all spiritual blessings in Christ Jesus in the heavenlies. So that what I'm going to point to here that underscores, you know, asking, what are we speaking out? What world are we creating with our words? For there is power in the things we speak and confess. And this is confirmed and corroborated by Solomon and the Proverbs, and then of course I'm going to bring up one by Jesus. The words that Jesus spoke, but Proverbs 18:21, and there's a couple different proverbs here that highlight this fact, but this one's pretty potent, right to the point. It's real sharp. death and life are in the power of the tongue. And they that love it shall eat the fruit thereof. Again, that the eating, you know, it's where we get the expression, eat your words. The fruit of our lips, the things that we're speaking out, because it's true, just as an example about how we are treating our loved ones, those around us, how we're treating each other, and of course, the body of Christ. But so I think it relates more to people and their siblings and the relationship of a husband and a wife, that we're speaking out those things and creating our world of love and unity, of life and not death. Nothing of, and praise God, I believe there's no one in here, but somebody on the YouTube might be watching or online, you know, that would create seeds of something that is, you know, you didn't do this, you didn't meet this expectation, all these things, your list of things, which doesn't even line up to, of course, remember what love is, 1 Corinthians 13, that Pastor Geneva was preaching on recently. But that would be out of some selfish thing and create tears. That would create things of controversy. And I know everyone's following me, so I'm not going to go deeper into kind of fleshing these out. But again, death and life are in the power of the tongue. The responsibility we have to keep the door of our lips, to have that watch, to have the word in us and meditating on the word every day, so that we're making sure that our speech, our conduct, our confession is truly the confession of heaven and Christ, so that we be not deceived. For as we know, deception is, I don't know what word to use to describe it. It's so brutal in the way that it works, that it deceives, that then you're deceived and you don't even know it. You think you're right, and it's the worst. But praise God, we have His Word. Let's keep it in us, coming out, meditating, confessing His Word. Remember more, Pastor Mark's talked about this, the meditating that it brings out, you know, meditate on these words of the law. It wasn't just, you know, sitting there quietly pondering. It was actually a speaking. It was a recitation. It was a reciting the word of the Lord, having it be a part of that confession, you know, to keep you from going off the wrong track, to veering off the wrong path. But the confession of Christ and the word, the living word of God. Hallelujah. Let's go to Jesus' words here at Matthew 12, verse 36 to 37. But I say unto you that every idle word that you may speak, you'll give account of it in the day of judgment. For by your words you're justified, and by your words you're condemned. Again, the power of our words, the power of our speech, the power of our confession, the power of the things we're talking about with others and our daily conversations, at our work, the places we are. Examining what that confession is. And tomorrow is Memorial Day, and many people will be celebrating with friends and family. We just had some of Allie's family with us, and it's awesome. And just make sure, you know, you have evaluated to, what is my confession? What is the witness that they are seeing of my words? And even more so, letting the Holy Spirit speak through you, those words that go into a person and they just get stuck, they can't get out of their mind, and then they can call you back up and say, hey, we were talking about this, I for some reason I can't get it out of my mind. The things that are as God would intend us to be bearing precious seed, to doubtless, most assuredly, come forth rejoicing, bearing our sheaves, that harvest that we've gathered. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. The Lord is so good. So this confession, there's so many places we can go. My goodness. Where's the time go? I've got to read 1 Peter. I'll read it fast. Bear with me, guys. I'm so blessed. Thank you guys so much. To where you guys get here and we go, I believe we went over an hour of just prayer and intercession. And let me take a quick break here to please be in prayer over the next. This was the first day. We got 3 more days to see just such change, such divine opportunity that's been given that we can participate in through the great power of prayer. To where we may not be there, but by our prayers, we're there standing with. You remember how they held Moses' hands up? And the battle, the enemy was just getting slaughtered. And then when Moses' hands fell, the enemy started pushing against and actually being able to overrun. But as we, through prayer, can lift up the hands of our pastor as he's doing the work of the ministry, the true work of an apostle, the true work of going in as the very mouthpiece of Christ Jesus and living the life of Christ and demonstrating the kingdom of God come, the kingdom of God here, and speaking that and speaking the things that we undergird him and also speak by the Spirit, not only mysteries, not only things that we don't know by the Spirit, we can't, but he'll also give us the utterances where we know, where it'll be fruitful for our understanding, where we can speak out directly in our own language, in the English language, sharp prayer. So I just petition you, please join in. We're, praise God, Pastor Ruth is going to share tonight about some of the things in India that was happening. So you don't want to miss that. Tell some people, if bless their hearts, for whatever reason they haven't been coming, that they want to be here to get to see, and that way they'll be sold. That way they can participate with what's going on in the prayer of Africa. We're not done yet. We're not done with this tour. We got a little bit more time where we need the saints joined together in collective prayer. So please, I beseech you, by the mercies of the Lord, to be in prayer with us. Almost there. We're almost there, and we see there's such an opportunity. That's why I just have to keep repeating it. Such an opportunity here, a once in a lifetime, as they say, to be meeting with these key leaders, chiefs, actually called chiefs and kings. Kind of amazing. Praise God. Let's go, 1 Peter 1. So please be in prayer. Peter, an apostle of Jesus Christ, to the strangers scattered throughout Pontus, Galatia, Cappadocia, Asia, Bithynia, elect according to the foreknowledge of God the Father, through sanctification of the Spirit unto obedience and sprinkling of the blood of Jesus Christ, grace unto you and peace be multiplied. Ha! Blessed be the Lord, be the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, which according to his abundant mercy, he has begotten us again unto a lively hope by the resurrection of Jesus Christ from the dead. My confession, I'm begotten unto a lively hope by the resurrection of Jesus Christ from the dead. That first fruits of the resurrection, that I can have not only the miracle of salvation, but I can have a resurrection when my body goes into the grave. I'll be raised up. Then, to be with him forever. Hallelujah. That we have the hope that when we die, and when we put off this earthly tabernacle, but we have one, a spiritual one, that our place is in heaven. Verse 4, to an inheritance incorruptible, undefiled, that fades not away, reserved in heaven for you, who are kept by the power of God through faith unto salvation, ready to be revealed in the last time. The confession that I am kept by the power of God. There's no greater keeping power. It's amazing. It's so amazing. Where we can look back and see and realize, even in the moment where we couldn't see, just how many miracles the Lord has worked for us on a day. How many miraculous things where he kept us by his power from everything, from accidents to just anything that would not be of God and his purposes. It's amazing. He keeps us. like the most loving father would keep his children. It's amazing. Kept by the power of God. And that's one of the gems here. There's many. Why I had to read this scripture. I'm going to read some more and let it just seed you here. You're kept. Your confession, I'm kept by the power of God. Hallelujah. Verse 6, wherein you greatly rejoice. Again, I'm rejoicing no matter what. If there's a calf in the stall, if there's fruit in the vine, if there's nothing there, I'm rejoicing. Wherein you greatly rejoice. Though now for a season, if need be, you're in heaviness through manifold temptations. That the trial of your faith, being much more precious than of gold that perishes, though it be tried with fire, might be found unto praise, honor, and glory at the appearing of Jesus Christ. I just got to stop here and say this. I've seen so many times where people were so close. It was like the last little thing that came out against them that the Lord allowed that then was going to take them. It was if they could just have kept their confession of the word of God and things in place properly, they would have gone on and it would have. But what happens is it stopped them and they held back. And then you see them out of church for a while and it's just like a spiral and it's brutal. It's just, I hate it because you know something was about to happen. And may this speak to each one of us to help fortify us and strengthen the word of the Lord and the strength and the power of his might. That don't let anything stop you, that be unstoppable. Be those who nothing can stand against. Be those unmovable, unshakable in Christ that you know and you keep your confession rejoicing. For though now it may be a little time, a little season in heaviness through manifold temptations, that the trial of your faith be found precious of gold, more precious than gold that perishes. And we know that gold doesn't perish easily. But in comparison to this faith that the Father wants to produce in us, it's as if gold perishes easily. But that faith, let him have his faith work in us by the confession that we are kept by the power of God. Whom having not seen, verse 8, you love, and whom though now you see him not, yet believing, you rejoice with joy unspeakable and full of glory. Rejoice in the end of your faith, even the salvation of your souls, of which salvation the prophets have inquired and searched diligently, who prophesied of the grace that should come unto you. And that reality that there were men of God, that they could only prophesy of these things, and it's here for us. Verse 11, searching out what or what manner of time the Spirit of Christ, which was in them, did signify when it testified beforehand the sufferings of Christ and the glory that should follow. Unto whom it was revealed that not unto themselves, but unto us did they minister the things which are now reported unto you by them that have preached the gospel unto you with the Holy Ghost sent down from heaven, which things the angels desire to look into. Wherefore, gird up the loins of your mind. Again, this is going into the confession. Gird up the loins of your mind, be sober and hope to the end for the grace that is to be brought unto you at the revelation of Jesus Christ as obedient children. That confession that I am an obedient child and I don't allow anything of disobedience, for I am an obedient child. As obedient children, not fashioning yourselves according to the former lust in your ignorance, but as he which has called you is holy, so be holy in all manner of conversation, because it is written, be ye holy for I am holy. Again, another gem here in 1 Peter about our confession being, I am holy because I am the righteousness of God in Christ because of such a great gift. Again, you saw me earlier broken, just talking about the communion table, talking about the communion by the body and blood of Jesus Christ that was shed for us so that we might be holy. We are holy. Be holy in all manner of conversation. In everything you're confessing. And if you, verse 17, if you call on the Father who without respect of persons, judgeth according to every man's work, pass the time of your sojourning here in fear, for as much as you know that you are not redeemed with corruptible things as silver and gold from your vain conversation, received by tradition from your fathers, but with the precious blood of Christ, as of a lamb without blemish, without spot, who verily was foreordained before the foundation of the world, but was manifest in these last times for you, who by him do you believe in God, that raised him up from the dead and gave him glory, that your faith and hope might be in God. My confession being my faith and my hope is in God. Seeing you have purified your souls and obeying the truth, I obey the truth. Again, the confession of obedience. Through the Spirit unto unfeigned love of the brethren, see that you love one another with a pure heart fervently, being born again not of corruptible seed, but of the incorruptible, by the word of God which lives and abides forever. For all flesh is as grass, and the glory of man is a flower of grass. The grass withers and the flower fades away. But the word of the Lord endures forever, and this is the word which by the gospel is preached unto you. So again, the confession. I'm kept by the power of God. I'm holy. My faith and hope is in God. And I'm going to skip over some of these other scriptures I thought I was going to share with you, but just reminding us of the holy, the Second Timothy 1, 9 through 10, who saved us and called us with a holy calling, not according to our works, but according to his own purpose and grace, which was given us in Christ Jesus before the world again, but is now made manifest by the appearing of our Savior Jesus Christ, who has abolished death and has brought life and immortality to light through the gospel. Again, the confession being, I'm holy. I'm called holy. And Romans 8:29, if you need to go, you can. I've just feel compelled. I've got to read 28 through 39. Romans 8:28 through 39. And we know that all things work together for good to those who love God. My confession is I know all things work together for good. Ha! Because I love God. He's my Father and he loves me. And as we're going to see at the end of this verse, it talks about this inseparable love, this unending, immeasurable love of God, that I know no matter what I see, no matter what I feel about any situation, because I've committed these things, that I'm in Christ, that everything that we've mentioned before about what our confession is, that everything's working together to good for me. I have no place to the enemy. I allow no place for sin or for iniquity. I'm kept by the power of God. And therefore, I most assuredly know, for the Bible tells me so, which is the most sure thing there ever is, because let me remind you, heaven and earth will pass away. Things will pass away. Our lives will pass away. Cars will pass away. Who knows if the Lord tarries, what will be the next vehicle? Started as a horse, right? So things are fleeting. Things are changing. But the word of the Lord endures forever. And I know, and my confession is, that all things work together for good to those who love God. To those who are called according to his purpose. And I'm called, that confession, I'm called. For whom he foreknew, he also predestined to be conformed to the image of the Son. My confession is, I'm conformed to the image of the Son. I'm conformed to the image of Christ Jesus, that he might be the firstborn among many brethren. Moreover, whom he predestined, these he also called. I'm called, that's my confession. These he also justified. I'm justified. And whom he justified, he also glorified. And I'm glorified. Just as Jesus prayed for us in John 17. Father, glorify them with the same glory that you've given me. That's my confession. I'm glorified, and I want to see that manifest more than when I go walking somewhere. People can see it all over your face. I'm believing for the greater works. You know, Moses had that lethal light, right? It's described as a lethal light where he was hanging with the Father. Talk about a witness. Your face is shining and whoo, your face is lit up. Wow. I'm believing for these saints. You may think I'm crazy. Hallelujah. Praise God, I'm not crazy. I just stepped out of the carnal, natural mind and into the mind of Christ to do His purposes. Hallelujah. And here it comes, verse 31. What then shall we say to these things? If God is for us, who can be against us? My confession, God is for me. Therefore, nothing can be against me. Nothing can stop me. No circumstance, no flat tire, no nothing. Especially from getting to church. No matter who's speaking. Because we don't look to the things of man, we look to the things of God. I tell you, it's one of those keys of revival. And I'm just going to share, and I know I'm going a little longer here, but remember that key that pastor told Evan Roberts? He said, when Evan Roberts asked about revival, the pastor said, be seeking God in every meeting because you never know. You never know which meeting it's going to be where your life is just totally wrecked. Totally invaded, probably a better word. Invaded, put together perfectly by Christ to then be a witness. And he was the man, if you go and look, you see that Welsh revival and the things that happen. And there's a lot I could share there, but you never know. Remember, God sees. And remember, those of you who are watching out the web, the apostle of this ministry proclaimed something that if you heard in your ears, you're accountable for. And that is, if you were in this region and driving distance, you're supposed to be in this place. Now, if you, I don't know who I'm talking here, Lord Jesus. If you want to stubbornly resist the word of the Lord, so be it. But I tell you, it won't be well. So please, please, recognize that you erred the way. And I don't know why. I'm reminded of the heir of Balaam right now. But if you're a part of this ministry, you're accountable for the word that you hear go forth. And so I pray. And let God be judge. But we don't want a false representation of this beautiful church, the abiding place that He's put here. What a glorious candlestick. And I know there's a place to comfort the weak and feeble. But there's some I'm speaking to, and I feel that it's that there needs to be change to go on. Oh, Lord Jesus, oh, Holy Spirit, I reverence the words You speak. Lord, I break at the thought that Your voice would be calling and be rejected. But not here, Father. Not here, Father. We thank You, Lord. You know those who are Yours. And thank You that You give us, by the Spirit, divine insight how we could help these people. Help the people around us that would become calloused to the words, that would think it's something of man when it's not. Oh, Jesus. Church, let us just begin to intercede even more for those around us, those that we can encourage, those that want truth, those who want truth, those who want change, those who are willing to say, to bend and break, to really say, bend me, God, and break. And the reason being, because when we have those people gathered together, God does such amazing things. And the people that come in, they witness the amazing things that God does, and it really just rocks their world. Oh, Jesus, we love you so. Verse 32 of Romans 8. He who did not spare his own son, but delivered him up for us all, how shall he not with him also freely give us all things? Who shall bring a charge against God's elect? It is God who justifies. It is he who condemns. Who is he that condemns? It is Christ who died and furthermore is also risen, who is even at the right hand of God, who also makes intercession for us. Who shall separate us from the love of Christ? Again, that confession. Nothing separating me from the love of Christ. So long as I'm willing to be broken and humbled, to recognize that of myself, I can do nothing. Shall tribulation or distress or persecution or famine or nakedness or peril or sword? As it is written, for your sake, we are killed all day long. We are counted for sheep, as sheep for the slaughter. Yet in all these things, we are more than conquerors through him that loved us. Again, that confession, I am more than a conqueror through Christ. For I am persuaded that neither death, nor life, nor angels, nor principalities, nor powers, nor things present, nor things to come, nor height, nor depth, nor any other created thing shall be able to separate us from the love of God, which is in Christ Jesus. Please stand with me. Again, this is underscored that all that our confession should be all things work together for good to those of us who love God. And what did Jesus say? If you love me, you'll keep my commandments. Hallelujah. So as we know that as we're loving him and keeping his commandments, all things work together for good, and that we are our confession, I'm called according to his purpose. And as you're standing, I'm going to read one last verse of scripture to you. 1 Peter 3, verse 10. For he that will love life and see good days, let him refrain his tongue from evil. Again, that confession, not allowing an evil confession. And his lips that he speak no guile, not allowing anything of our mouth that would be guile, that would be slander or anything that would not be of an honest, just report that has virtue in it. Verse 11, let him turn away from evil and do good. Let him seek peace and pursue it. For the eyes of the Lord are on the righteous, and his ears are open to their prayers, but the face of the Lord is against them who do evil. The greatest confession of all, I am Christ. That we have been delivered by such a great miracle and gift, that we've been bought with a price. And the confession, I am called to live the life of Christ, and so I will do so. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Oh, we love you, Lord. We love your ways. Lord, we thank you for the region of Congo. We thank you for it, Lord. That the Spirit of the Lord break through upon them like the bursting of a dam. That there be such an outpouring of the Holy Ghost, even as Pastor Mark is preaching. As he's ministering, we're right now, whether it be on the laving of hands or still by the spoken word, proclaiming your word, the mighty signs and wonders. And we thank you for it, Lord. Thank you all again, saints, for being here. And those of you who were here from the beginning, as we went for over an hour praying and interceding for the Congo region, great things. Great things are happening. Key things. Keep them in your prayers. Those of you who have purpose in your heart to give of your first fruits, you may come forward and do so, that offering, that bringing your best. Again, we've talked about, I've highlighted it from the beginning, everything about being punctual and on time at the start of the meeting, because it's all reflecting our life, and what we're saying is an act of worship to the Lord. We're saying, Lord, I give you my best. Lord, I'm not going to be on time for some other commitment, whether it's play, whether it's work, whether it's whatever it is that I've committed to, that I would be on time for and then late to your house. No way. Not going to have it. So the first fruits, bringing forth the first, the best. That's what the first fruits speak of. That we're giving him our best, a true acknowledgement of our best, the best of our time, the best of our life. Hallelujah. So praise God that you're going to encourage the brothers and sisters next week when Pastor Mark is back. Everyone's going to be on time. You're going to be plenty of time. Remember, the house, his house is called a house of prayer. I'll be here praying. Remember, it's the our test time is coming. Our evaluation time is coming. How much have we grown in the last 30 days? Ask yourself that question. How much have I grown? Have I slacked off in any way? Have I become lukewarm in any way? And I pray not be so. Let it be a challenge. We've got a great week this week. We've got Remnant. We got Brother Pat Schatzline this week, Friday, Saturday, Sunday. So those of you who, everyone, I would ask, evaluate, please, and see, and say, look, in the truth, Lord, is there growth? If there is growth, don't just be like, thank you, Lord, for growth, that I have growth. I mean, that's good to say, but evaluate. Really say, where's the growth? What has changed? When I come in here, what has changed? What has changed? Am I worshiping the same as I was 30 days ago? Like this. Seriously. No joke. Praise God. I won't share some of the things I see being up here. You got a full view of everybody. But praise God. Praise God for his church, the abiding place. But look, guys, let me just encourage you. I was sharing this with the youth. We just want to see into the realm of the eternal, where these angels revealed to us, even in Ezekiel, how they worship God with such abandonment. You know, and it just, as a testimony, let it be something new. Let it work something new in you. Maybe new for you is raising your hands. Well, praise God. Maybe new for you is a shout. Maybe you in the middle of worship isn't just the song, but you begin to break out in the Spirit song. And the song in the language of the Spirit. Or you begin to break out in prophecy. I mean, that's what we're going for in the edification, right? So I just want to encourage you. We have one more service coming up. And I believe some of you youth are going to be sharing on Wednesday night to seed some of the rest of us, to challenge some of us about street evangelism and share some of the things that are going on that the Lord is using us in. Let me say it one more time, because it's so important. I believe it most important in our spiritual walk. What is the testament of our growth? What has changed? What can I see? Do I find myself praying deeper? Do I find myself being closer? Do I find myself more overwhelmed in the presence of God and more sensitive? When I come in here, even more so, I feel the glory of heaven in deeper ways. Come on. Let's be real. Let's be real here. You can't tell me. that you're having growth when the Spirit of the Lord doesn't move you in the church. I tell you, there's sometimes where I can't even move. I begin to sob or weep or laugh, and it's just uncontrollable. I pray, let that, if maybe that's not you, maybe you're somebody watching on the web right now, your experience is you can barely open up your mouth to sing, standing like a statue before the King. Terrible place to be. But if that is you, start with something. Get something moving. Oh, for the Lord is a rewarder of those who diligently see Him, seek Him. Oh, Lord, we want to see you in our midst in every one of us. We thank you for growth. Hallelujah. But let me just, again, to reemphasize, where's the growth? Where's measurable growth? Where's measurable growth? We have an opportunity. If you don't have anything, man, I can't think of any area that have had growth. You have a chance. We have some flyering still going on for Pet Shots Line. You can get involved with that, at least moving out with evangelism. Begin to move and watch God as you move out take you to places as you speak. You're like, wow, that was so fun and exciting. And I got to experience speaking on the Lord's behalf instead of being busy about my own things. Something else not working out and making me sad and dried out like a prune. Where I got nothing to give and I stand like a statue. But praise God, you know this. You know what I'm saying. Most of this isn't here, but it may be a challenge to each one of us. To me, even. I'm saying, I'm just bearing my heart before you guys. I'm just like, what does worship look like? Am I supposed to run around the room with my guitar bouncing off walls? You know, what is, I'm just being serious. There's a way that man has modeled, and there's a way, a model that God has for us. Doesn't matter if it's the best worship team you know and the way they do it. Let's go for revelation. And you guys participate in that as the body members, right? And it does start with getting excited, and you know, we have to be really careful that it's not just a playful thing and a free-for-all, of course. That's all right. But you know, when you have it before the Lord and you're saying, Lord, I want to begin to worship you. With my very guts, with the deepest parts of me, with the things that you formed from the very tiniest molecules of my body where I could get moving in you, moving for your glory, that I can give you that praise. I don't know if I can call it gyrations of heaven, but it's just moving. It's a holy movement. Praise God. Hallelujah. So bless you guys. We love each and every one of you. Please come back tonight. I'm so excited to hear some of the miracles that have happened in India. And those of you who have stood with us in prayer for that, kind of getting these witnesses of the fruits of also our labors as we were laboring with Pastor Mark in prayer. And of course, he had to do the biggest part of the work. We just had to pray and get the refreshment of heaven as we're doing it. Because there's a refreshment that comes. He gives us, and let me encourage you guys with one more thing. I keep just saying one more thing, but there's a refreshment. There's a place that you can touch. And Pastor Mark has said this many times, and I grew up hearing it. And I remember at about 9 years old where it became real to me. About the spirit realm where your body can be tired. And then you step over into the spirit and it makes alive your body. And you know something, Christ within you, something's alive. And I pray every one of you have that experience, that you feel deeper urges in the spirit, deeper emotions than you ever had. God is a God of life. The dead cannot praise Him. Those, the life, the issuing. Some people say, yeah, that person was just so full of life. Well, God has purposed us to be that. Oh, and even more so in the church where we get to come in. As a church, the fullness of Him that fills all in all. Hallelujah. So let Him just show you that. And let it begin Let it begin to now. Now, let it begin tonight when we're coming together. In expectation, you never know what's going to happen. You never know if we're going to be called to intercede for something. If we're going to be called as a body to immediately go out, we need to be prepared at a moment's notice. Ready. 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 Who knows? Soon the Lord might have us. Next Sunday, he says, all right, Abiding Place, you're going out. I got a bunch of people for your reach at Mir Mesa. Something. You have to be ready. But, you know, I won't say that. But let me just encourage you. Remember, we got to, there's things. Yes, there's things that come out against us, to rock our world as we see it. You know, but this unstoppable place. Pastor Ruth has this powerful message that when she shared with me about the untouchables, and it's amazing, and I'm not going to share it, and I don't even know if she'll ever share it. But just this place in God, and just such sold out, not just the acknowledgement, the confession, but confession with action, right? And that's what this is. We're talking about the things we're supposed to be confessing. But it's not just saying them. But it's a true confession in that we do them and we live them. Praise God. Hallelujah. We love all of you. Greet those around you. If anyone needs prayer, we'll be happy to pray with you. Otherwise, we're just going to be up here worshiping. Again, let the Lord take us deeper than we've ever been before. Let us just go deeper into the realms of heaven. That place where we draw nigh to God and He draws nigh to us. Wow. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you for your glory. Thank you for this place, your church. This holy, holy place. We are yours, Lord. We are yours, O Lord. We are yours, Lord. We are yours. Your sheep, the sheep of your pasture. Good Shepherd, we are yours. We are yours. Your will be done in us. You will be done in us. You will be done in us, Lord. In your church, in this earth, Lord. You will be done in us, Lord. You will be done in us, Lord. You will be done in us, Lord. We thank you for this life you've given. We thank you for this love you've given us. That we will bless the Lord at all times. That your praise will continually be found in our mouth and in our lives, O God. That our confession will always be that He who is mighty is done mighty and so great things for me. Thank you. Lord, we say thank you.
say thank you. Lord, we say thank you. Lord, we say thank you. Lord, we say thank you.
love all of you. Thank you again. Thank you for prayer and intercession for the Congo. Praise God. If there's someone you haven't hugged, hug them. Tell them you love them. If anybody's, looks like the Spirit of the Lord is on them and moving and things are happening, just leave them alone. Keep things, of course, sacred and reverential in this house. We love you, each and every one of you. Be blessed.